Hey everybody, welcome to ADSR. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on social media for all kinds of great information and content coming at you daily. I'm Stephen with Intervoice Media, and today I wanted to talk a little bit about using send effects inside a machine. Well, what's a send effect? Most of you are probably familiar with insert effects. That is plugins that we insert on a sound, on a group, etc. But a send effect is a little different. It's common in a recording environment, in a mixing environment, where we send a copy of the signal to a processor that then brings its signal back to the board, or machine in this case, and we can control the return level separately. It's called the effects return. And the benefit of a send effect is we can send multiple different signals to that send effect, and then have it just coming back as one signal that we can blend with our mix, with the original sounds. So to that end, I've put together a very simple little down-tempo beat, and it's got a main beat, a topper beat, a bass, a pad, a pluck sound, and a bongo. And that's really about it. Let's give it a listen. Okay, it's a pretty cool little beat, but we can add some more depth, some texture, by using these send effects. And so the group that I've got it on right now, I've actually gone ahead and inserted a number of different effects plugins. So let's actually go to this group, and we can see I've got a jazz hall, kind of a hall reverb, an 80s snare reverb, and a dark plate reverb. And then down here I've got a replica, which is a delay by Native Instruments that I'm a real big fan of. And then the simple delay preset for the delay plugin, the beat delay plugin in Maschine. So the way this works is any signal in our entire beat or song can send a copy of itself to any of those effects. And we can do that off of sounds or off of groups. So to get started and demonstrate this, I'm gonna go ahead and solo my main beat. And let's give it a listen. All right, there's some neat stuff going on there. I'm gonna unmute my effects group so we can hear the result of it. And then I think, with this snare, let's go ahead and send a copy of that snare. Make sure I got the right one. Oops, sorry, it's a clap, I'm sorry. So let's go ahead and send that to that snare verb. And now our level is gonna be controlled right here. And I'm sending this post, meaning the level of the original signal, the clap, is going to dictate proportionally the level of the send. So if I change the level of the clap, it's gonna change. And it's not just this that controls it. Let's hear it now. So the cool thing about these send effects is I can go over to that group, and there's my clap reverb, and I can go to sound and actually control the return level. So already we're blending some signals. So that's a pretty cool way to work. Now I'm gonna add this topper beat in, I'll solo that out. And let's give that a listen. All right, pretty straightforward, nice chilled out little thing. Let's do this on the group. So I'm gonna select my group instead of a sound. And let's send this to that hall. And bring it down just a little bit. And another common use of a send effect is as a delay. So I'm gonna go ahead and send this to my replica, which is just set up on a nice, simple, straight eighth note delay. And let's hear that now. All right, so I've got a little extra depth and texture. It's one of the nice things about using a send effect is I can reinforce current rhythms or add new rhythms in by blending multiple signals into that delay unit. So let's hear those two beats together now. Already a lot more happening. I've also got this bass in here, and we generally want to avoid using especially reverbs with bass because they just add a lot of mud and it really takes some of the clarity and punch out of your mix. So you can do it, but generally speaking, you want to avoid it. But let's hear it with the bass. So let's hear that pad. All right, and I think I want to send a little bit of reverb, maybe a little bit of that. Let's use the dark plate this time. And let's hear that. And I'm also going to add a little bit of that delay. Cool. And we've got this pluck line happening. So I think for that, I really like using a plate on a lot of percussive tight little elements. Works well for plucks. Just adds a little bit of a shimmer. And we'll also, let's use our other delay and see what happens there. Cool, I can work with that. And lastly, I have this bongo. And bongos in particular are most hand percussion, shakers, congas, etc. I find works really well with the plate reverb. Just adding that shimmer and a little bit of extra energy, not too high. And mute it, mute the effects to hear it back and forth. Okay, and maybe just a touch of that straight delay here as well. So just not very much, and let's hear those together. So these rhythms that are already working in my piece now will also be creating delays that'll work together in a different syncopated rhythm that I can blend in. Let's hear everything together now and see what we've got. Definitely a stronger, more dynamic, and more interesting piece at this point. So for comparison again, I'm gonna mute the effects and unmute it a couple of times as I play it so you can hear the difference. So wow, that's a pretty big difference. Definitely a neat way to add that energy and texture. So another cool thing we can do with this is I can go to the effects group itself, and again, I can control the level of any of the particular groups by adjusting them, either here on the software, or if I go to the sound and just click audio, here's my output level. I can adjust this is the output of my reverb. Likewise, here's that snare verb we're using. And So we can adjust the levels of any of these individually, and then we can always go to the group and adjust the group level. And on the hardware, again, we're just choosing either sound or group. So if I'm sound, adjust the reverb. And I can select any of the particular or the whole group. So there you have it. It's actually quite simple. And I hope you find this technique useful. If you have any questions, please leave a comment on the video page. And make sure you do subscribe to our YouTube channel for lots of content coming at you every day. Thanks a lot. And I'm Steven with Intervoice Media, and we'll see you again real soon. Take care.